Hi my Coco fam, welcome back to my Coco channel. If you're new here, welcome. I have so many new subscribers. Hey, the Coco fam is growing day by day, and I'm happy with you guys. So welcome to the Coco fam. Today I will be doing a second video related to the first one of last week, because I got so many messages of people asking me about more tips, more things that you should know about here living in the Netherlands. So here you go guys, I'll be doing a second video especially for you guys, mentioning all the things that you should know living here in the Netherlands. There's so much things that I won't cover all those things, so let's start. Let's grab the notebook and let's begin. First one, there's so much laws here in Netherlands. It's really important to learn and know the laws, because people have the tendency to fool you often here in Netherlands. So it's really important to know your laws. Netherlands, it's organized, semi controlling. Why I say controlling is because it's so organized that you feel like they're almost controlling your life. You feel like when you have to poop, they know when you're pooping. It's really like that. But it's really organized, especially the government sites. When you log into your DGD or if you call the gemeente, they can trace back your calls and see when was the last time you called. So Netherlands is really organized, controlling. So that's one for sure. Third one. Here in the Netherlands, you really have to get a bicycle. If you don't have a bicycle, you don't count. It's a lifestyle here, it's a trend. It's also the most inexpensive thing to have, because you can travel from one part to another part easily on your bike. Also, it saves you so much money instead of going with the public transportation. But the con of having a bike is it gets stolen easily. Even if you lock it, if you don't lock it properly or whatever, I don't know how, but they finesse and stole the bikes easily here in the Netherlands. So I don't recommend you to go buy an expensive bike, because at the end, all your money will be gone. I personally don't have a bike because I don't know how to ride a bike. Like, don't judge me. So, but I really want to learn how to ride a bike, because I think it's so cool to have a bike here living in the Netherlands. Talking about bike traveling and everything, with the public transportation, you can ride zwart. They say zwart rijden. This means that you can easily just travel from one part to another part without even paying, without even checking in, because you have to check in with an OV card, OV chip card. But you can choose to don't check in and don't check out at the end and save some money. But you just have to be alert when the conductor are controlling in the trams, metro or train, if the access door is open, or if you just go behind someone, you can just finesse the whole ride. So that's it. I done this a few times just to save some coins. And don't be like all nervous and everything. Just chill with the vibe. When you see they're controlling, you know, quickly check in or whatever, or just stop at the next stop and get in the next tram or metro or whatever. So yes. Next thing is you can save a lot of money by train if you buy your ticket online. If you buy your ticket on NS app, I swear you will be saving so much money. So many people don't even know about this trick yet. I even found it out myself recently. But I'm going to learn my cocos today about this simple, affordable, inexpensive saving money trick. So, let's say you want to go from The Hague to Dordrecht. Yes. Or any of those Drechts. Because you have Dordrecht, Barendrecht, Zwijndrecht. Anyways, a whole lot of Drechts. But you can't afford to pay the fee from The Hague to Dordrecht. You can easily put your rent from The Hague Central to Rotterdam Central and pay 8 euros, for example. I'm just going to say something right now. Let's say the rate will be 8 euros, right? You will be paying the 8 euros online on your phone. You have the barcode to check in, check out, bling, bling, bling. And it says on the card, enkele reis, which means you can only use this ticket once. Which, there's the trick. It's a lie. It's a lie. You can use this trick. You can use it, this ticket the whole day till 12 before the next day. The whole day. I ain't even lying. I save coins every day on this rate. You just have to finesse them, you know. You have to be smarter than them. Next one. It's easy and inexpensive to travel to other countries in Europe. Here in the Netherlands, you can travel anywhere you want that's part of Europe. Let's say if you want to go to Paris, you want to go to Spain, you want to go to Portugal, you want to go to where's the name of this thing again? Hey, I just mentioned a few. It's so inexpensive. You can find traveling tickets starting from 15 euros. It's so, literally so inexpensive. You will often need to use maps and walk with a portable charger. Why do I have to say this? Because if you have to go to a place if you've never went before, you will get lost easily. So you really, really need your Google Maps to instruct you. Okay, you have to go here, there, left, right, straight, backwards, everything. You really, really need a Google Map app to instruct you where you're going. And why the portable charger? Because this consumes all your battery lives. Using just maps, it takes so much from the phone battery. So it's really, really handy to have a portable charger by hand. Also, if you get lost, you can call somebody. If your phone don't have battery, who are you calling? How are you going back? Think smart. Next one. Important. Be on time. Here in the Netherlands, the people are so precise with appointment and everything. Wait. Yes, here you really, really have to be on time with appointment, everything. Because if you're even 2 minutes late, you won't even get your appointment. You have to make another appointment. So always be on time. You don't have much food varieties here in the Netherlands. You will only get like kapsalon, Surinam's food, sometimes Chinese. Sushi, those types of things. It's not the thing that I normally used to buy in Curacao. In Curacao, I think we have more options than only these things. Getting free food. You can easily also get free food. Let's say once I was at a friend and we ordered Domino's and the pizza was cold and it didn't have all the things that we asked for. So we called and we complained about it and they bought the whole order for free. For free. And I was like, okay, I'm going to try this at home myself. And it worked. Literally, I ordered pizza. It was good and everything. But I was like, you know, I want to eat one more. So I called and complained about the pizza and they bought another one for me for free. So just don't go overboard with it, because then you will ruin it for everybody else. Dutch treat. Dutch treat is really known here in the Netherlands. Dutch treat means everybody pays for their own things. It's not like, okay, I will be paying for you. No, everybody pays for their own things. If you're following me on Instagram, you already saw on my Instagram story that I posted a story about a packaging that was about to arrive at my address, and I put it in a poll so you guys can vote if I should open it in my next video or not, and you guys voted for yes. So I'll be doing this right now. This is the packaging. I'm putting my hand so you can see my address. This is the packaging. It's from my girl Flawless Glow. She's a wax specialist in Rotterdam. She's the best, literally, she's the best. She takes her time to get rid of every single piece of hair. She has so much patience. You feel at home at the salon. It's a whole chill vibes. I really, really recommend this salon. Enough with the talking. Let's open the packaging, you guys. Let's open the packaging, Cocos. There's a seal right here. I'm so excited. Let's see. I don't even have a slight idea what it is. Okay, I'm lying. It feels like leaves. So I think it's related to the, you know, vaginal wash thing, or vaginal cleaning thing, you know. But we're gonna see right now. Let's go. Let's go. I'm really, really. Let's see if it's still recording. Yes. Okay, let's. Yes. I'm really, really, really excited for the packaging. Let's open it. Let's open the packaging, guys.
Oh my gosh, it's so good to feel. Okay, drum roll, please.
Let me show you guys first, and you guys are going to let me know what's in it. I don't know if you guys can see what's in it, but let's see. I'm so excited. I see so much things here. Okay, there's, okay, I have everything. Yeah! I told you guys it's something with leaves. Okay, let's read what's all those things here. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, let's start with this one. Let's start with this one. It says, V-Steam for home use by Flawless Glow. V-Steam is a traditional, blah, blah, blah. Okay, I'm just going to read it real quick and then I'll get to you guys what it is. So yes, guys, it's officially the V-Steam. You guys, I wanted to purchase this thing so bad for a long time already, and right now I just got it for free. For free. You know, it smells like what's the tea that we use in Curaçao? There's a specific tea that we made in Curaçao when you're sick. I think it's lemongrass, I think they say it in English. It smells so good. It smells so good. I got also two gift cards, one for me, one for a plus one. Oh my gosh, Coco's plus one. It's 20 euros. Oh my gosh, girl, I love this girl. And let's see what's in the small packaging. So cute. It's written Coco on it. Oh my gosh, you guys. For Coco, just a little thanks for the nice videos and your trust in me. Oh my god, girl. From Manuela. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, girl, you're making me cry. Oh my gosh, this is so, so sweet. Oh my gosh. And I also got a discount card. When you get the card full, you get a 30% discount. Oh my gosh. Hey guys, you have to check out my girl Flawless Glow on Instagram and Facebook. I'll put the link in the description box for you guys and also pop it on the screen for you guys. Oh my gosh, girl. Thank you so much, and I can't wait to try this. Go follow me also on Instagram so you guys can know how everything went and alles drop in the runs. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Thank you, girl. I really appreciate you. Oh my gosh, the Coco fam is the sweetest. I swear. It's easy to bring things back when you don't want them anymore, or if it doesn't fit, or it wasn't your expectation, or whatever. It's easy to just bring them back and get your money. My best friend, literally, everything that she buys and she didn't like it, how it looks in the house or whatever, she will bring it back. Everything she brings back to get her money because she doesn't want it anymore, or it didn't fit like she wanted it to fit. So it's easy to just bring things back when you don't want them or it didn't suit your expectations. I once ordered a tripod and it says that I received it at my address and I didn't. So I called them. I was like, yeah, you guys told me that I received it, but I didn't receive no tripod. Even though my neighbor took it for me. But at the end, I got my money back and I still got the tripod. So yeah, things happen. If you're 18 plus, you're allowed to buy weed at a coffee shop. Here in Netherlands, weed is completely legally, so if you're 18 plus, you just can go at a coffee shop and buy your weed. Sometimes as a woman, you don't feel safe at all here in the Netherlands. In Curaçao, I can walk at night, or it doesn't matter the time, and I'll be okay. I'm okay, you know? I feel low-key, I'll feel safe. But here in the Netherlands, when it's too late, or especially in the winter and it's too dark, when I have to walk alone, I'll be so alert of everything, every movement. Everybody that keeps looking at me, I'll be like, I think it's time to run, because I really don't feel safe here in Netherlands. That's one thing I really have to say. You can collect water bottle, beer bottles or whatever, and you can get money back from collecting them. I have a whole collection of water bottles here in my kitchen. At the end, when there's too much and I don't have space anymore, I return them back and I will get like 7 to 8 euros back for just returning them back. So that's also a way to get some money. Dutch people loves to overshare info. As we say in Papiamento, na gustaría do. Dutch people, literally, when you talk with them, they overshare everything. They can tell you they were married to Cas. Cas broke up with them. They got a kid by Peter. Peter broke up with them. Peter don't want to raise the kids. They will tell you everything and in details. And they also expect in return that you tell them about your life. In my culture, we don't do that. We don't do that at all. I can tell you like, yeah, I have a boyfriend. Or I can choose to don't tell you that, no, I don't have a boyfriend. And I know for sure that I have a boyfriend. So that's one thing for sure of the Dutch people. They literally gusta redu. There's so much microaggression in Netherlands. For example, when people give you racist comments, but they can brush it off easily. I don't know if you understand me, but let's say they can just came to you and tell you like, oh, you speak Dutch very well for a Antillean girl. What are you trying to say? And when you cuss them or when you say something about it, they will be like, no, I didn't mean to say that. It wasn't meant like that. You know, that's microaggression. Here in the Netherlands, you will get this often with the Dutch people. I don't have nothing against Dutch people at all, because there's a few of them, they're literally schatjes, but there's other ones, racist, okay, let me say racist as fuck. Every year you can fill a document to get your taxes in return. This is called aangifte. It's a good money that you will be getting in return after 1 year. It's a good amount of money, you know. Fill that in. Don't forget about it. Don't. Apply for allowance for housing, health insurance, kids and daycare. We call it in the Netherlands toeslag. You can get money for almost everything to help you pay your house, to help you pay your health insurance, help you with your kids, daycare, everything. It can be clearer than this. It will help you also financially to save some coins. Last one. If you don't have a degree of, let's say, university or whatever, if you don't have a diploma, you can easily go to a MBO school and just get your diploma there. With an MBO diploma, you can do everything. Everything. You can get work everywhere that you want. I know people from 30 years old that are doing their MBO at the moment. So don't be ashamed if you don't have a diploma or if you're going to a MBO. Nothing. Yes, Coco, that was it for this video. I hope this helped you guys much more. And I hope you guys have a nice trip to the Netherlands or enjoy your life here in the Netherlands. Bye-bye, Cocos.